That is not the resolution that is supposed to be. Hold on one moment. Is it really so hard to get it to render at the right resolution? Hello. Hello, Saya. I said prequel. How is Zero not a prequel to the first one? Why is it called Zero then? I say work wasn't bad. Also, I just updated PCSX2 to the current version, so I apologize for the weird how it looked at the start. Wait, if it's a prequel, then why isn't it 2.5? If it's a prequel to the third game, shouldn't it be like 2.5? I know what's going on. Good, that'll fix it. Wait. Yes, we're having subtitles. Mortal Kombat 9 called Mortal Kombat because the AAA devs don't give a fuck? What? They're real weird. The first two games are in this strange real canon. The third one is a simulation of dystopian... Okay. 045673. Well, I've played 4 on stream, so clearly I played them in the wrong order.
Thank you. Oh, him? Yeah. I know him. It's going to take a while.
Let me know if it's too loud.
It happened years ago. Did you know there are three kind of aces? Those who seek strength, those who live for pride, and those who can read the tide of battle. Those are the three. And him? He was a true ace.
He was a fighter pilot they called Solo Wing Pixie. He was a colleague of the man I seek. 10 years ago, there was a war that engulfed the world. The Belkan War. And in that war was a pilot who trailed across the sky and disappeared from history. He was a lone mercenary who inspired both fear and admiration. He is the man I seek. And so, with the words of Solo Wing, the curtain rises.
It was a cold and snowy day.
Listen up. We have a situation on our hands. A major squadron of Belkan bombers has crossed our border, and it's making its way here, to Valet Air Base. Apparently, they intend to attack our base in an initiative to gain hegemony over the entire Republic of Ustio. Valet Air Base is our country's last line of defense. If our base falls, no one will be left to stop Belka from taking over Ustio. Your mission is to destroy the squad of bombers and defend our base. Belka's invasion must end here.
Krius, I believe Goat Simulator actually skipped the second game. Goat Simulator completely skipped 2 because they claimed that they were never making a Goat Simulator 2. So there's Goat Simulator 1 and Goat Simulator 3. Hey, Bennifer, how's it going? Hope you've been having a great day. Hold on. Try it now. Doing good? Assuming you don't have any money, so...
But...
Okay. Tell you why everyone has to slam the door. Oh, I do have 2 different planes. I have a Draken and a Tiger. Clearly we're going, what, surface to air and, no, what the hell's a SAM? I don't know what a QAM, what a QAAM or RCLR is. Oh, hold on, there's 3. I'm blind. It's an RCL. Quick maneuver air-to-air missile. A SAM is semi-active, okay, and what's an RCL? Oh, perfect, rockets. It apparently tells us. Okay, rocket launcher. Thank you. Look, you just have to, for after all, what is man in nature? A nothing in relation to infinity, all in relation to nothing. Central point between nothing and all and infinity, far from understanding either. What are the controls, by the way? The game still hasn't told me. I just know that yaw is L2 and R2. Get up by not crashing. Does the right stick do anything? Camera, okay. This is somehow worse quality than Nexus Head. What about Assassin's Creed? Or a sab that whatever the hell it was. Okay. I need to know more than missiles is square. Tell me more than missiles are square. That was not square, that was circle. That was a lie. Legitimately, it says missiles are square. I press square. Nope. Clearly, you meant circle. What range do we have to get in for the missiles? 4,000?
One enemy bomber down. Continue with operation. I'm gonna come out on top today. Second enemy bomber down. Stay sharp out there. That's enough battling.
Well, this is easy so far.
Thank you.
Well, for the first mission, it's easy, as it should be. You know, that's technically correct. Forgot to turn on the air conditioner. That's an AC, please. God damn it. And for air conditioner. An alternating current, an AC-DC. What the hell is AC-DC? I actually did that immediately first thing, Wu-Tang. I just set them to cover me.
It all started on that snowy day.
How's it going, Fish? Sorry I missed you before. I was trying to figure out what the fuck is going on.
He had potential.
Thanks to you, Belka's attack on Valet Air Base has failed. Your efforts will not go unrewarded. Your actions may well decide who wins the Belkan War.
Is Mercenary or Knight better? Yes, Creus, I don't know who AC/DC is. And also, A-Style, what does that mean? No, I don't know the band. Fish, I don't know music. It's morality bar. No, I don't like, look, I don't like music, so I don't listen to music. I keep the radio off in my car when I drive.
The Belkan War is shrouded in mystery.
Or I'll put on a talk show.
But now, a decade after the peace accords, a portion of the records was finally released. I quickly got
yes, Fish. You got it right.
Wanting more details, I acquired information from unknown sources. There was a reason for my obsession. The roots of the war lie in the Belkan Federal Law Review that took place in 1988. Belka, suffering from economic strife, permitted its eastern territory to secede. And the Republic of Ustio was born. But Belka's economic troubles did not subside. Meanwhile, taking advantage of the situation, the world superpower Osea continued to flourish. Amidst the economic panic, an extreme right-wing party took power within Belka, aiming to restore strength and stability to the nation. And on March 25th, 1995, with the discovery of natural resources in Ustio, Belka began to invade its neighbors. It was the beginning of the Belkan War.
Wu-Tang, should I completely cripple this entire video feed
right
now?
Each country fell quickly before the might of the legendary Belkan Air Force. In just a few days, they occupied all territories except for the mountain range. In response, the occupied Ustio government military placed all their hopes on a joint operation between Osea and the foreign mercenary forces. This, of course, can be found in any history book. But I noticed a strange similarity in the materials I gathered. There were several accounts about a mercenary, all followed by the code word demon. But most of the information
was
incomplete.
That's a demon word, but
still, I was intrigued. I decided to pursue the history of the Belkan War through this mercenary. I was certain I would find something there. Would it be the hidden truth behind the war, or just another battlefield legend? I wasn't able to meet the mercenary himself. Actually, it's questionable if he ever did exist. But thanks to some old friends in the military, I was able to track down several individuals who knew him. Soloing is one such man.
I wish I could change the keybinds to this game already. Wu-Tang, have you seen the God's Drunkest Raven stream of Armored Core Nexus?
We must regain control over Route 171, which runs through Arlen to secure a transit route for our ground troops.
Oh god, it was awful.
Along this route, three over the RA River, all heavily guarded by the Belkan Armored Core. Securing this route is critical to Ustio's attack on the Belkan forces. Destroy the Belkan ground units blocking passage along this route.
Here you go.
Supply line between our forces and the Ocean Army.
I timestamped it for you. Honestly, you only have to watch like 10 seconds of that Wu-Tang. Doesn't help with unknown going destroy, destroy. Who am I picking this other one? Oh, the wingmen. Yeah, I don't really like music, no. For after all, what is it? Oh, is this just gonna say this over and over again every time? Wu-Tang, that is the God's Drunkest Raven filter for Nexus. And hello, Matt. Look, Fish, I didn't listen to Eric to sing because I like music. I did it because it was funny. Gotta stop doing that. Sounds like I'm not supposed to kill those yellow ones. Also, I skipped this by accident. This is just them just taking off. Oh, I get to actually take off myself! That's awesome! Hey, Dober. Well, someone redeemed it and it came up. No, Varyag, I just wanted to do this part. I honestly thought I skipped a cutscene or something. I don't know what that means. Was I supposed to get somewhere within that time limit? Oh, I wasn't high enough. Okay, whatever.
This is AWACS Eagle Eye to GOM. The target is in formation along the highway. Commence the operation.
The barrel roll was worth it. Manning officer, the jet is not painted pink. Hale, this is the 90s. Oh, I think I just killed someone. Oh well. He should have ejected faster.
I'm sure this fight will change the look of this place. The owners of those houses will probably be back once this war is over. Where the hell are those reinforcements?
Radar lock. Sam destroyed.
Or was it Wu-Tang? I've played a lot harder playing games than this. Oh, they didn't give me time to kill off the planes. Plane is reaching for a gun, you should shoot it. Bomb by Mini Irby's? Honestly, I would love to replace the bombs with just dropping Irby's.
Mission was a success. Passage along Route 171 has been secured. Thanks to you, Ustio will now be able to launch a counterattack. Operations has issued an emergency order for a reconnaissance mission to be conducted near the border. You will be monitoring the airspace B7R, currently under Belkan control. Strong opposition is expected by enemy squadrons, and the presence of a magnetic field has been detected.
What's wrong with you, Wu-Tang?
In short, this will not be a walk in the park. The B7R airspace is located above an area rich in subterranean resources, where many conflicts have been fought in the past. You're authorized to engage enemy planes upon contact. The time has come for your skills to be tested.
No one's as bad as Slippy in expert mode, slamming you in the back and taking your wings off. Again, it's the same quote. Not gonna remember it. It sounds not correct.
Belkan Priority 1 Strategic Airspace B7R, aka the Round Table. It was the grand stage where we pilots performed. We were all on an equal footing, fighting under the same conditions. No affiliations or ranks to hinder us. Aces from every nation crisscrossed through those skies in pursuit of air superiority. The only rule of engagement was to survive.
Comm team, this is Eagle Eye. Penetrate B7R and get a feel for the surroundings.
Comm 2, roger. This kind of job is what we're all about.
Enemies on radar. Exercise caution.
I'm assuming I would need flat ground.
Comm team, we cannot authorize a retreat. Intercept them.
I figured you'd say that. This is gonna cost you extra.
Unlike you mercenaries, I fight for a real cause. The ones who survive are those who fight for their convictions.
This is the round table. Dead men's words hold no meaning.
Yep, have fun. Good for them. Don't get off your ass. Oh, that guy made a mistake. Hold on, that guy just did a 360 in place. I was watching that. Planes can definitely turn a lot faster than my planes, so that's kind of an issue. Okay, got him, finally. Good, we got him!
All Belkan reinforcements confirmed down. Mission complete. Return to base. Incoming message from Allied Forces Operations Command. Allied Naval Force has begun its advance. We appreciate your work.
Looks like we were just a couple of decoys. Yo, buddy. You still alive?
It seems B7R is more heavily guarded than we thought. If it wasn't for you, this ploy of ours probably would have failed. Keep up the good work.
God, the non-target ships aren't even freaking, like, their planes aren't even, like, close to being worth anything. Now I see what Wu-Tang was talking about were for just the civilian casualties.
Joint campaign. The collective strategic military force of the two armies will be referred to as the Allied Forces. The campaign will be called Offensive Campaign Number 4101. The objective of this operation is to secure a sea transit lane for the Allied Forces. To secure this channel, the Belkan forces occupying the Futuro Canal must be cleared out. You will be given a choice of missions in this joint operation. Offensive Campaign Number 4101 will be comprised of the following three air missions. First,
I have not.
Operation Gelnikos. This is an air-to-air surface operation whose objective is to wipe out Belka's air squadron, port facilities, and surface weapons. Next is Operation Round Hammer. This is an air-to-surface operation whose objective is to wipe out the Belkan fleet, its port facilities, and surface weapons. And the last mission is called Operation Costa. This is an escort mission, whose objective is to protect the naval vessels in Osea's Third Fleet, including its state-of-the-art aircraft carrier, which will be making a trial voyage. Fierce resistance by Belkan forces is expected
in
three missions. Choose carefully which one you wish to participate in. That is all.
I don't know what any of that means, Stinger. It's why they put a $72,000 plane in here! Fuck you! Oh, god damn it. So, people keep mentioning the buddy thing. Also, the pilot doesn't actually move much. Go off, my friends.
Calm team, commence operation. Eliminate the threat north of the canal.
There's the counterattack signal. I've been waiting a long time for this day.
Secure a route of passage
And directly reads the force the pilot puts in the stick, good for precision. Awkward at first airflow into the plane. What is CS2? Why does it want to focus on the barracks and... So, why does the button that's meant to change target not go on what's towards the center and cycles through whatever the hell loaded all the way in the back? That's so aggravating. I should not have just gotten shot there, but it doesn't choose any of the target, like this guy. Why do I have to cycle through the entire list? Oh, that's awesome! Thank you! Oh, that's perfect! Thank you. This is literally everything that I've wanted. Well, that's your shot at Barrick.
Ground forces have been eliminated. Continue to engage the enemy fleet.
You aren't gonna let me do this, right? There's no way.
Warning, the enemy's tracking you.
Oh, good, it didn't work. I was about to say, if that freaking worked. We need one or two missiles for the ships. Two, okay. Nice. Oh yeah. To be honest, Taylor, it would be really shitty if you had like four freaking missiles.
Operation Roundhammer was a success. It goes without saying that your actions greatly contributed to the overall success of campaign number.
Thanks.
comprised primarily of OSEA's 101st Airborne Division over Solus Ordis in a surprise air and ground attack on the Balkan forces. This operation will play a critical role in Bustio's liberation. Your mission is to provide support for the airborne troops. Destroy Belka's surface-to-air defense network and all interceptor aircraft, securing a safe drop zone for the airborne troops. Be aware of civilians still inside Solus Ordis. Your actions will determine their fate. Good luck.
Stop trying to hit the civilian tent.
Warning, the enemy's locked onto you. Break, missile. SAM destroyed. Missile evaded.
There's too many to cover.
Missile,
soldiers in the shoot drop.
I think I'm getting the dog fighting in this game down.
Approaching gun range. Bandit down.
Hey Matt, thank you for the Carolina Reaper nut. So, very funny is that this game won't stall the AI to chase. God damn, another nut.
Airlift operation was a success. All enemy forces near Solus Ortus have been eliminated. The rest is up to the ground forces. GOM team, mission complete. Return to base.
God damn it, Matt. Oh, right, when I had the grape that was grapefruit juice. Well, that was easy. Oh, John Cena didn't work. Hold on.
Nicely done, Gom 1.
I'll go play that. Very fucking loud. And his name is John. Oh, it wasn't loud that time. Huh. God, that thing is broken sometimes.
Operation Varsity succeeded. Ground troops are now en route to Solus Ortus. It won't be long now before Ustio is liberated.
I barely got paid shit for that. Oh, I did miss a nut. Ace poverty zero.
Preparations to liberate Directus are now complete. I will now brief you on the Ustio 6th Air Division's role in regaining control of the capital. Directus is divided into 5 administrative wards, centering on the River Crescere. Powerful weapons have been placed in each ward, comprising the Belkan Army's Ustio Branch headquarters. This battle will determine our fate, as the annihilation of all enemy forces will mean liberation for the nation of Ustio. The enemy forces are primarily comprised of ground troops, but we have received information that, while not yet confirmed, there is also a squadron of high-tech enemy fighters. Your orders are to destroy the Belkan forces and liberate Directus. We can't afford to lose.
Start the operation. Release 5 sectors under Belkan control.
Cypher, let's do this right. We've got the pride it takes to win.
Locked on. Enemy armored vehicle destroyed. The tide should turn once they get their capital city back.
Leaving the battlefront. Looks like they're running scared. Sam, does
sectors have been liberated.
The city has fallen to the Allied forces. Any soldiers left, open up an escape route. We lost. The Falcon Army. We've been defeated. We got our city back!
They've got a reason to fight. This battle's over.
Warning! Warning! Enemy reinforcements approaching!
What? Now?
Two craft approaching at high speed.
Let's take care of them.
Intercept.
It doesn't look like they'll let us head back to base unless we take out those two planes.
You do. Stop that awful bell from ringing.
It looks like the Allied forces have taken control.
Start the operation. Release five sectors under Belkan control.
Cypher, let's do this right. We've got the pride it takes to win.
Let's go!
sectors have been liberated.
The city has fallen to the Allied forces. Any soldiers left, open up an escape route.
Hold on, was my mic not broken? Yeah, the fucking mic was broken. I had the mic off. God damn it. When I was eating, I didn't realize that when I turned it off, I didn't turn it back on. Oh, there we go. Long story short. I was talking to you guys the whole time. I didn't realize you didn't hear me. But yeah, anywho, these guys are very fast and they can apparently shoot backwards. But thankfully, this game doesn't have the enemies stall. So because they don't purposely stall, I can just win. Man, is he fast though.
I know Cypher and Pixie can get the job done.
There we go.
Airspace threat eliminated.
Yeah, I just got destroyed the first time, not realizing how fast they were and that they could shoot missiles backwards. Clock business, what? I've got to try this. Can I land? Damn it, too late.
On May 13th, 1995, Ustio was finally liberated. The tide of war was about to change dramatically.
Velka's Ustio branch headquarters has fallen. Directus has been liberated. I just received a vintage bottle.
I got paid good for that.
For the GOM team. It's a hard to find Cabernet. Perfect, I'd say, for celebrating an occasion such as this.
Oh, I got an S rank. Nice. I didn't realize I was getting ranks. I haven't been looking. Hopefully they've been good. Bye. Have fun.
The true nature of the war begins from this point forward. Accounts vary depending on the article and source. Everyone is a hero and a villain, and no one knows who is the victim and who is the aggressor. And what is peace? All questions commonly asked about any war in history. As the battlegrounds move to Belka, he is also thrust into the middle of this war. This is also where my interests shift from the war to him.
Intelligence reports that Belka is developing nuclear arms and V2, a weapon of mass destruction. The Allied forces' top brass have decided to send troops across the Hydrian line into Belka to check for nuclear arms and secure resource interests. Centered on the ruined base of Gladysand, the Hydrian line, Belka's long line of defense, stretches 700 kilometers from Osea's southern border to the border of Safin. Situated at the peak of Mount Evrea, the ruins of Gladysand have been transformed into a modern base with anti-aircraft artillery and a powerful defense system. The Galm team's mission is to launch an aerial strike on Gladysand, opening the door to Belka for our ground troops. In all probability, this will be an extended operation. You will be able to refuel during the latter half of the mission. If you're low on fuel, temporarily withdraw from the battle and return to base. Good luck.
Terminator. Well, we're buying the massive Gripen upgrade. I'll grab those next for 30k. Good. Covered. Oh, never mind. These have been changing each time. It's so esoteric and pointless, I haven't noticed. These are changing.
Tom 1, you are cleared for takeoff. A nuclear inspection, huh? What a joke.
Fire away at Gladysand. Your job this time is to take out their defense mechanisms. A return line is located on the south side of the operation airspace. All planes can pass over this line whenever they need to resupply.
They're here! Commence firing! One little mistake and it's all over.
Officer 7 here. I've been hit.
Sand destroyed.
Fire a missile into the hole.
Just don't bite the dust.
Stay alert, Amy.
locked on.
I have to get used to the other new, like, plane. It's definitely, it can, this one can definitely stall a lot faster.
Box 2. This is Area Gate, the player's broken out inside. Sector A has been taken care of. Head for the other sectors. Locked on.
Oh, I accidentally skipped a cutscene, that getting blown up, but oh well. That missing?
This will be a springboard to nuclear inspection. We've got to sink that fortress.
AA guns destroyed.
Stop the Allied forces at Gladysons. Falcon is just behind us.
Fox 2.
Cooperate with all areas and take out those
more attacks are coming from Sector B. Sam destroyed. Missile evaded.
Hey, let's go restock. Hey, Ragdon. Yeah, the game's not bad.
There's a fire creeping up with explosives in that tent. Get away from it.
Roger. Only release of special weapons. Roger.
Mechs that just fly and don't walk. Interesting. Hey, Visic, how's it going? Yeah, we're not gonna go through the landing minigame every time. Oh, the rocket launcher's been very useful so far. At least I've been getting use out of it. Everyone's been telling me it's bad, but I just disagree. It's just not easy to use. Hello, Mr. Quadman, yes.
I've diverted from formation. Are they still flying?
Locked on. GOM-1, missile launched.
I've run out of missiles. Returning to rearm.
Warning, the enemy's locked on to you.
How did I miss that shot?
No matter how many we shoot, they'll only just keep coming. How many fighters have they sent here?
Oh, no, that time I know exactly how I missed it.
Golem 1, missile evaded.
I'm in trouble here. I can't evade all this at once.
I can't bail out. It's hell out there. I don't want to die.
Warning, the enemy's locked on to you. Locked on. Missile warning. Missile evaded.
Okay, rocket time. Everything I had to kill over here? It was, yes. Okay, last place, let's go. Come on, Pixie. Don't know if I need to pass that score if getting there auto wins. Hail, that is awesome.
No can do. All hands are currently occupied.
Players are poking out in sectors 1 and 5. I'll help you prepare yourself.
Yep, night hail. I'm probably getting off after this anyway. Yep, it apparently is.
Attack powers have been neutralized. All planes return to base.
Did something just flash?
Should have definitely not killed as many ground targets and gone to those bases. Probably worth a lot.
Gladison has fallen. The Allied force.
Yep. Should have also listened to that. I keep skipping that. Because they keep starting it late, you don't realize there's dialogue. Well, I'm going to cut it here then.